Marc, a 2-0 win here at Leatherhead. Can you give us your thoughts on the match, please?
Well, I was just disappointed. The game was broken down a lot into so many fouls, and it made for a really scrappy game. But a blistering start. Got to see some of the quality that we've got here. You know, Briggs, Rutherford, two great finishes inside the first 10 minutes. Kind of felt at that point Leatherhead didn't feel like they could get anything from the game. A lot of fouls, broke the game up, hard to get into a rhythm. But, you know, credit to Leatherhead because, you know, they're a club, you know, on their way back. They're not entitled to beat us at the moment. You know, we've got to be honest with ourselves there. We're a league above. We've got bigger resources than them right now. So, you know, we really appreciate the competition. I'm sure in years to come the boot could be on the other foot. But no, I thought the game would show some quality, which is great. I thought the small fouls really sport it for the supporters, really. That's the bottom line.
Okay, and there was lots of good individual performances. One being Alfie Rutherford scored two goals in the opening 5 minutes. Were you really pleased with his performance?
Yeah, delighted actually. If I could have chosen anyone to score to that, been Alfie. Alfie's he's a finisher. He can score inside the box, outside the box, headers. You know, he's a real poacher. He plays for scoring goals. His hold-up play is brilliant. His intelligence is great as well. So, it's great to see what's about to come. And there must be something about people making their debut against Leatherhead because obviously Barham got three in the FA Trophy game. When Alfie got two, I thought, here we go, another hat-trick coming. But no, it was great. I thought we were a step up on where we were Saturday. We took the game, two games in the weekend. We gambled a bit, really, because Luke Moore, Niall McManus, Sam Beer, Ben Dyke, they're all injured. And when we got new players, I like to try and blend in the new ones. We play a very particular way, and it takes a long time for the new players to get the hang of that. And I think, for me, the supporters need to be patient with that as well. I'm sure they will be. They're great fans. But, yeah, you're not entitled, I just said there to Gary, you're not entitled to be like a PlayStation team because you've signed bigger names or better names or higher up names. It's going to take a long time to bond the team. It may take even a couple of weeks into the season for the boys to really start finding their feet together. So at the moment, it really is just work in progress. And it is a bigger building job than we've had before. We've got up to 7 or 8 new players. When you include Kennedy and Wheeler that didn't really kick a ball last season, and the new signings, you're talking, it's 7 or 8 players that arguably are in the first 12, 13. So it's going to be a big job to actually blend them in. So at the moment, it's just about each game, increments, just trying to improve. But delighted to come out unscathed. Ed's hamstring was a tweak, so we just won't bother with him this Saturday. And hopefully by the week after, he'll be right as rain.
Of course, and talking about this Saturday, Potter's Bar Town at home. Can you give us your thoughts going into that match?
Well, my thoughts are that supporters should be able to go. At the moment, they can't. What we saw here today was a football ground that's typical non-league ground, loads of space, 600 people I'd imagine on the button, sellout, completely safely distanced and having a great day out. And the fact you can't just do that at any ground is scandalous. And if we can't do it next week against Potter's Bar, then ultimately, you know, that's kind of, you know, £3,000 to £5,000 straight away that the club has to forfeit for no good reason whatsoever. So I think we're looking forward to the game, but if it's behind closed doors, I just think, you know, that's going to be really disappointing. I'd like to think, but I doubt, that they'll put a ruling out this week that says it can happen. But I think the FA just all too easily just sit there waiting for someone to tell them what to do. And no one's going to tell them what to do because they don't always get it. So, yeah. But, sorry, long-winded answer. We're looking forward to the game, but if the fans can't be there, I'd rather find a neutral venue or something. In fact, we should probably try and find out, if we play a team in a league below their ground, can we have supporters? That's an interesting one. So we might have to find out that one.
OK, Marc, thanks for your time as ever, and we'll see you Saturday.